Okay, well, if you can hear me, I think we're just gonna keep going then, because I think I figured it out.
I can hear you now a
All
lot
right.
better. Yeah, because you'd talk and then all of a sudden, like, boom, you were gone again. You wouldn't finish your sentences.
Well, that's good that we figured it out.
I still like how everybody complains on your YouTube channel that can't hear us.
Yeah, so, I mean, you can hear me. You're a little bit... It's hard because, like, it's much louder in my headset than it is in, like, what it's recording, I think.
Yeah.
And
well,
you could go
turn your headset down and turn us up.
I could do that. And then in iAction, it tells you, like, it records the mic. It's kind of like a mixer. Like, it will record less of my mic and more of the... like sounds like what would be you guys and like all the other sounds on the computer, so I have it now, so you guys are just a little bit more quiet than me, but I think it's good that you can actually hear what I'm saying now, so I'm not just talking to myself.
Yeah, because that's what you were doing. Like, it's like you said, it's like you start talking, it wasn't on continuous, so you'd say like 3 seconds worth of
yeah. So I went to TeamSpeak and I switched it from like, it was set at like push to talk or something. And so I put to continuous transmission. So I'm assuming that's what fixed it, so.
Are you coming back this way or are you going to go around the long way?
I think I'll come back and just make a big headland and.
Then go make the headland on the other side? I was gonna say Colby should have that old head. His internet ain't good enough to download new stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it made sense that it was on my end then if Colby couldn't hear, so.
.450's having a little issue pulling this.
Well, you could tell we put these beans in quick, missed the whole section right there.
Looks like we put some in the ditch, a couple pieces of corn in the ditch. We didn't do a very good job.
A few little things of corn. Oh, there's another miss. I didn't spray this field, so.
No.
Everything that's. I didn't spray any of these fields down here, so.
Looks like there's a few misses in here. I think that was a lot of planting at nighttime because you can't really see.
Yeah.
Going.
Well, the nutrients over here are really high, so.
10 and 4? That's how 24 and 14 were, or 23 and 14.
We don't have 23.
Yeah, we do. Oh, 24 and 14. Those yielded pretty good corn.
I think the only thing I did over there was put down lime.
They were at 10 and 10 and 2 or 10 and 4?
Yeah.
It varied, but yeah, it was good corn for what little pieces of the field they are.
I'm gonna have to go back in and like single player and use like course play to figure out what's the size of some of these fields, you know?
Yeah, so we can accurately do the.
And then make a Excel sheet to see what the yields are per acre. At least figure out what kind of acreage we're running, you know? I feel like if we were to pick up 19, 29, and 23, we'd probably be around like 900 acres, I think, or 1,000 acres. Because I think I did the math at one point, and there's close to like 2,400 farmable acres on this map. I think.
You cover more than that in your sleep.
Gang wide, that's a lot. Definitely, put it that way.
Even in real life, 2,400 acres is a big operation.
That's why we have a 1500 Kinsey on a 450 horsepower tractor.
We're small time right now, really.
Where's my T9 700?
I think I'm going to buy a cat next.
I like that idea. Kitty looked good on this. And that 2623. Colby's going to be in love.
Yeah.
RT on a 50-foot disc.
I was using that 9RT, and I haven't used it in a long time, and the windows bug me. Like, they're too shiny inside. What was that?
My text message told me.
God.
Wow.
It's a screaming goat.
I'm not even surprised. Like, literally nothing you do would surprise me.
It used to be the flirting whistles. We'd walk through the mall, and my buddy would text me, and it do the flirting whistle, and everybody sit there and look, and I just keep strolling along. Because you're not bothered by that. I have no shame. You need help? You need a push? I'm right behind you. Do it like beet harvest.
Jesus. That's so obnoxious. I could rent another draper if you want to do draper work, or...
No, it's fine.
You just content?
I'm just content playing with this new toy. Mike got to play with it all night last night, or Saturday. And I never got to use it yesterday, because none of you would get on. You missed some beans.
Not worth the fuel to turn around to go get them.
Don't worry, I'll make it right.
He's just gonna mow them over.
They won't mow over.
With your tires?
Yeah, they won't mow over. They just drove over.
I think you took out a couple of them.
I know, man, I got the right tire carrying this spot.
Now we're at 9-3 over here.
Yeah.
8-3.
The sides of the fields were different then.
I have no idea how these fields get so variable with their nutrients. You know, we put down the same thing, same crop, like, everything is the same, and then after, you know, 4 or 5 seasons, it gets so variable. It's like...
Yeah, it's like real life. Different part of the field is different. Just wait till we start putting manure down.
We don't have any manure.
We don't have any cows yet.
No. So I was thinking if we were to do 20 in as alfalfa, we'd actually make twice as much as on that same land as if we were to do corn. Because
so
that.
You're just gonna leave 20 as alfalfa.
Well, what do we get? Like 70 bales off of that?
I think so. Remember, we gotta mow that before the third green stage. Find out if it leaves tire tracks, because we're gonna murder that alfalfa. Oh crap. We're gonna murder that alfalfa.
No, I mean, the way it works is, our tires are behind the front mower.
Yeah, but when you merge it, the tires aren't behind the merger.
No, it only destroys the crop after the third growth stage, and when you mow it, it cuts it back to the first.
No.
So you can drive over it all you want after it's mowed, and it won't wreck it.
Oh.
Okay.
So.
Are you sure the mower covers the tires?
It's the same thing with, if we were to spray, we could go up to, like, the third growth stage, you know, like 3 weeks in and not really wreck any of the crops, so.
Yeah, just, you have to spray at the last possible moment.
Yeah, because once it goes, then it's like the fourth and fifth, the second to last, and then obviously the last, which would be this. So if I would have sprayed a growth cycle before I did, we wouldn't have lost any crop, but you know, we lose such a little amount compared to like what, how much we improve the yield by spraying, you know.
Yeah.
Some of those fields I put down PK, NPK, and lime. You know, I put down three applications and I just was in the same line, so I didn't wreck any.
Good thing I wasn't driving.
Yeah.
Are you going to do another headland on that side or just leave one?
Do I really need to do another one?
No, you're that good of a driver. Hey, over more. How fast are you cutting?
7.5.
Well, that ain't bad.
Yeah, I went to buy those MacDons and I couldn't buy them, so I don't know what happened, but they used to, I don't think I did anything to them, now they just don't work, you know?
Yeah. They're nice, but, I mean, the 45 is going to get us more done in a period of time.
Yeah, that's why I just said, screw it, I'll go with this, I'll fix it, make sure the joint on the combine doesn't go down as far. It had, like, a min rotation of, like, 25, so I just put it to min rotation of 12, so.
Looks like the one side of your header is higher than the other.
Yeah.
There's that big spot. Oh no, those are your tire tracks.
What's different with the draft control that you put in there?
Leave tire tracks. That means no joyriding around your fields, Colby.
When I installed that, I'm like, oh, Jesus, Jake's gonna bankrupt us.
How? You complain enough that if we drive there, so. I've been driving on the roads lately to make you happy.
Yeah, except during great demands, you guys just cut right across the field. Roads? Never heard of them. This is a nice area of the map over here. Lots of trees.
Yeah. I'm about to get murdered.
Imagine if we had two 45s on these little fields. Just boom.
Oh, yeah. That'll be a nice thing to have, though.
We do. I mean, 60% of our land's drapers, so.
Probably will be for a while.
Jake's whipping shit.
I didn't hit it. We're good. The cart is too big for the tractor.
Yep. Well, that cart's what? 14? No, 12? Tons or something? I don't know. Something like that. It's a heavy ass cart.
1,500 bushels is probably 80-some thousand pounds.
Yeah, but the empty cart is pretty heavy itself.
The tractor looks so small up against it.
Yeah, that 450 is...
Not liking it.
That sounds familiar.
GPS?
Yeah, that's the Green Star sound we got in our tractor and stuff.
Yeah. Hey Jake, have you seen any of those cat locomotives? I don't think Jake's here.
I hear somebody breathing.
Is it me?
Oh, I think it's Colby.
Might be lucky to get a truck off this field.
Pretty big field.
Yeah, it don't look like there's much in there. Sure taking you a long time to get a big load with a 45-foot head. Of course, you got a big bin in section.
It's going up pretty good, I mean. I wish I had a real-time yield calculator, you know?
That'd be nice. Step up your game, Giants.
Well, I mean, they had the speed and RPM, so I imagine shouldn't be that
difficult to script in, you know?
No.
You would have to, like, figure out how to read the working width of the cutter. Because it'd be leaders coming in, working with speed.
Yep. Distance.
You'd be able to figure out your liters per area.
Well, you can go a couple more rounds. I'll just lay back and kick the feet up. Walk around this little beauty. Oh, looks like we got a bolt coming loose.
You want a combine?
No, I'm good. I'm eating right now, so it's actually perfect being a car driver. Fat man is hungry. Plus, you never get to combine. I'm always the one in the combine. Kind of nice to change it up.
I did all the spraying, but like when you guys weren't even on, I sprayed all those fields. It was like...
Yeah, now you know how we feel.
What do you mean?
What do you
mean? I did more spraying than you guys. I literally sprayed for 2 weeks, and no one came on.
Nobody knew you were on.
That whole big list of shit to do, I did that all myself.
Mateus didn't get on because the boss wasn't on. The boss was busy with school. And the grunts were busy doing other stuff.
Yeah, I was MIA for quite a while.
I was playing Xbox One.
I don't know, I had a 360 and I don't know. It's just so basic.
Yeah.
Gaming consoles.
Yachts came out for GTA for the Xbox One, so I had to work my way up to one of those.
A what?
Yacht.
Oh.
Good thing it's not like corn, at least you can unload it before we get to it.
Yeah.
What's all beans? 10,
there's quite a bit over here, and then 18, and then
44.
Yeah, 44 is a big bean field.
Wonder if we'll be watching your video or not. He's lying.
I hear you. No, I haven't watched the video.